Hi. So now this is day 5 core Java class. It's okay. So now today we are discussing, or we are going to discuss about the, we have already seen about the basic of variable, right? In that, two things we have seen. One is the class level variable, and second option is the local variable. About class level variable and local variable, more detail we will see. Means this again will be segregating in two forms. I'll write it here, which is, you can say 1.1.1, which is an instance variable, and 1.1.2 is the static variable. We will talk about this later on in more in depth, what is the memory allocation process and when memory will be allocated, what will be the class loading timing, and all many other things are there in that. So we'll come to that point. Now before that, there is one very important question. Apart from this local variable, we have got to a point is the called as the constant. We have got a very important point, constant. What is constant? So what we have seen about the constant is that is constant in Java. What we have seen about the constant, that if you declare a simple variable int a is equal to 10, this is a simple variable in Java. So why we are calling this as a variable? A is equal to 10. So why we are calling this one as an, why we are calling it as variable? There is a very basic questions related to this. It is variable due to some reason. See here, what happens that for A, some memory will be allocated, in which, actually I'm just trying to represent the memory. So in this memory A, which has been allocated by A, value 10 will be assigned, and the value which has been assigned for this A, the memory which is going to allocate according to the data type it will allocate, which means that I can say the memory allocation, for a variable is, it's according to the data type, so that is 4 bytes of memory it is going to allocate, 4 byte of memory bytes you can say it is going to allocate, right? Means another form, what I can say is, if somewhere I will try to initialize A is equal to 20, then I can do it easily. Here you need to understand one point. If technically we will say that what is the variable, so can I say one important thing, that the memory which has been allocated by A, and in that memory location the value 10 which has been assigned, is loosely coupled with the memory location allocated by 10. Loosely coupled in the sense that any point of time, if we want, we can change the value of A. This is what I want to say in this. At any point of time, if we want to change the value A, we can easily do this. But so we can say this as a variable, that the variable allocated memory and the available value in that corresponding memory location is loosely coupled, right? So what we say, there is a option called as I am talking about constant in Java. Constant in Java. If suppose, first of all, in Java, no concept of constant. Even important point is const key word is available. This is available. Const keyword is available, but again I can say we are not allowed to use. In another form I can say that we cannot use the const. So I wanted to declare a constant in Java. What could be the definition of constant? You can tell according to your views, right? Can you tell me, like as I have told you, the what could be the variable properties? A variable should be like what? Similarly, if we say that it is a constant, so what should be the property of constant? Can you explain, please?
The value cannot be changed all the time. It is constant. You try to not allow to change the value.
Exactly. So we need a, in another form I can say that the variable which is there, the value of the variable can be changed at any point of time, right? Int A is equal to 10. The value of A could be changed, but at the same time we need something that the memory which has been allocated by A, and in that memory location what value is available is tightly coupled. It should be tightly coupled, I mean to say. Means the value of A, even if we want, we cannot change in future. That is one thing. Even if we want, we should not be able to change that in future. We want that property. And in order to achieve that property, in the case of Java, we are writing here, declaring it here as a final. Here, what is that final? Final is keyword. Final, what we have is the keyword. Final, we have declared it as a keyword. So we must have to declare a variable as a final. Then we will, we will not be saying it as a constant in Java. We will say it is a final variable in Java. We will call this one as a final variable in the case of Java. This is what we have here. Okay. Well, other than this now. So I am just writing here some more things. Suppose we are writing one student, or let's say better we write here the student. About the student, we just wanted to define some of the properties. So can I have one SID?
Yes,
name of the student, city of the student, and DOB of the student, and country of the student. We can have like this, country of the student. Okay. In all these properties, in all these sort of properties, what you want to declare that property as a variable and what you want to declare that property as a constant?
Date of birth as a constant.
Okay.
I know. Student ID means it depends, but yeah. Remaining everything we can define as an like whether it's a string or an integer.
No, I'm not talking about a string. I'm not talking about data type. I'm talking about that one student is there, right?
Uh-huh.
One student property is there. So in a student property, there are following properties are available: SID, name, city, DOB, and country. Out of this, what you consider that which one should be final, means which one should be final and which one should be variable?
The date of birth can be a final.
Okay, that should be a constant, right? And
constant. The student ID also like can be a final. We cannot be changing an ID.
Okay, consider a requirement. Consider a requirement, Sri, that suppose this is your student class. It is a student class. Okay, na? It is a class called as student. In that we have this several fields. I'm having SID, name, city, date of birth, country. Can we have it?
Yeah.
Suppose what is student? Understand like this. So it's a very simple topic. I would have completed in a very simple manner itself. Means like a final variable, which means you declare the value variable as a final, that will be considered as a final variable. We can do like that, but I'm just taking you some other kind of explanation for this. So student is a class, right? Class, what is that now? Class is the student. About this class student, what all different objects could be there? Or you can say in objects mainly, you say. So number of students, suppose some SRI Sri is one student object of the student. SOM is one student object, right? It is some again. Some Santosh is one another student object. See, they all are having these properties. Understand my point? They all are having these properties. Getting it? They all are having these properties: SID, name, city, DOB, and all. But these all are a separate entity. Sri is one separate entity. I'm a separate entity, somebody else is a separate entity, but we all are student, right? So now in this sense, if Sri is there, see here, I'll write one point here, make it clear here, that if SRI is there, one student reference, so what is the ID of the SRI? 101, maybe. Name of this SRI is the name of this. City is what? Suppose Hyderabad is the city. Date of birth is what? Something is the date of birth. Country is what? Suppose India, we can have the country, right? Now, at the same place, SOM is there. What is that now? 102 is the my ID. Name is the SOM. City is again, suppose you can say Bangalore. Some date of birth is there. We can write some date of birth. And again, we can have what now? India is the country. Now, you just observe one thing. Up to an expected point, or suppose we consider one more property for the student, let's say CO college name, and suppose we all are from the same college. College name. So if we all are from same college, so some JTC is one college name we are writing. Fine. Now in that, what you are expecting, that has to be common C variable, which needs to be changed every time. What we are getting confused, general, according to me, it is again, it is my idea, my thinking, and the way I have thought. See, SID, can we make it final now? Can you tell me? Now, by saying this requirement, can you say that? Can we make the down the SID as in final?
See, yeah, because
SID is final. It is fixed. But it is only for the SRI it is fixed. In a project, we cannot make it fixed. Why we cannot make it fixed? Because one person is having separate SID, somebody else is having separate SID, somebody else will be having separate SID. Name, we cannot have it fixed. Your name is different, my name is different. We cannot have city is a fixed, we cannot have date of birth is the fixed, but up to an expected form, if we consider that we all are from India, so India could be the same. Means it could be declared as a constant, because for all, India is the country. For all, suppose college name is the GTC, right? So India, the country which is there, is common for all. So the data which is common for all, why do we need to declare it again and again? So the question is, what kind of property we declare it as final? What kind of property we declare it as in final? Right? So, which is common for everyone? Which is common for everyone, that we would like to declare it as a constant. Why we'd like to declare it as a constant? Because everyone is having the same value of that corresponding property. Everyone is having same value for that corresponding property. So, if it is same value, then why do we need to write it again and again? Getting it? Why do we need to write, let it be constant itself? So we can have the constant.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yep. I'm just, it's not like I'm teaching you at all. It is the general thing, general option, which we can use in our daily life. You can also think like that, right? So if something which is common to all, we will declare it as a constant, which is my personal data. That won't be constant, because the some data which is personal to me, sometimes it could be personal to you also. So if I will declare that as a constant, then in that case, that my personal data could be same for you also, and could be same for me also. Correct? See, sometimes what we are saying, if we will consider this scenario, so let's consider a bank requirement. Let's consider the bank requirement, bank details. In bank details, we will say account number. Account number, name, suppose debit and credit amount, you're suppose linked with the loan account number, and many other details could be there, right? It is. See, account number, do you think that it should be a constant?
No, it will be.
I don't think it should not be a constant. See, we are getting confused with two things. We are getting confused with unique property and constant property. It should be a unique for all the customers. Account number should be unique for all the students. SID should be unique, correct?
Yeah, I'm getting it. Yeah, unique and fine.
It should be unique. But it should not be the constant, so that everyone's, and yes, if it is constant also, so it should be constant for the particular instance itself. For SRI itself, it should be the constant. Means wherever we talk about SRI, 101 should be the constant, but it's not like for the entire field we can make it the, so that is the reason we call that in Java there is no constant. We will call this one as a final variable. What we will call it as a final variable. Did you got it?
I got it. But why we are not saying it's a constant that you are saying? Okay, it's a final, that I understood. Like, if that is a common data, then definitely we will make that as a final. Hmm. But why that, though we have that constant keyword, you are saying that we are not using that one.
Yes, we are not. See, the Sun Microsystem, they have allocated, they have kept it in the reserved keyword list. Reserved keyword list, in future, maybe they can use that const keyword for some other properties.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Okay.
It is in reserved keyword. Now you see one more point. I'm taking a bit more time to explain this, but it will be again a concept building for you. Okay. Now, we can declare. Okay. Here itself, you tell me one thing. That suppose India is the country. We know that if India is the common country for everyone, for all of us, right? So, do we need to write country name again and again here? Is it required? Not required at all. Not required at all. Right, it is. So, because it is unnecessary taking the memory. If you consider, here is it allocating some space. Here also it is allocating. If you write 100 times, it will be allocating some spaces.
Yeah.
So now again, we want a constant, we want a final variable. We can declare country and college name might be the constant, final variable. So final, by declaring it is a final, we are making one thing fixed, that particular instance we won't be able to change the value of that corresponding variable. But parallelly, now I have second requirement itself, that what is my developer thought process is, that suppose the data which is common to all, why do we need to write it again and again? Why do we need to allocate memory again and again? Why can't, suppose here, it's all the lists, we can have the data like this or not. We could have the data. See, what I can do is, I want the property should be like that. India I'm writing, suppose. When I'm writing India, understand it point. So let's allocate memory for India only once. if we can have that feature like this, if we can have the feature like this, that the India, suppose this is the country, right? It is. So let's memory allocate memory and once again, one only, and the 101 student is there, they should also point to the same memory location, and 102 student is there, they will also share the same memory location. So if they will share one memory location, so number one is the, we can stop the wastage of memory allocations. Number one, if it is a common for all, so why do we allocate again and again? If it is common for all, we can allocate memory at one place itself and that can be shared by all. It makes sense, right? If it is common for all, if this data is common for all, why do we need to allocate memory again and again? That's my question.
Static or something, yeah.
Yes, that's what. So now we have certain way of declaring the variables. What is that certain way of declaring the variables now? See, number one way, first one, I can declare final int of a is equal to 10. It's a final variable, but when you will declare the final variable in this format, then the memory will be allocated again and again like this. Okay, na? Now, second option is a static final int ab is equal to, let's write here the ab is equal to, let's say I'm writing 101, and the third option which I write here is final int of capital AB is equal to 202. Now say here some basic differences are there in this. For this, memory will be allocated again and again, depends where you are declaring. Number one, memory be allocated again and again, as per the object creation. Object creation. As per the object creation. Depends that this final variable has to be declared inside in class L directly, which becomes the final instance variable. Second point again, when you are declaring the variable as a static final variable, a static final variable int ab is equal to 101, so ab, no doubt it is a static final variable, ab which is there is the static final variable. So for this, memory will be allocated only once. For this, or for, you can say static final variable, memory will be allocated only once, not more than once. Memory allocation will be only once. And there is no difference between second one and third one. According to the Sun, now you can say Oracle. It is recommended to have a final variable name. Static final variable name in caps letter. It should be in capital letter. It is a recommendation. It is a suggestion. It is a convention. It's not a rule. You want, you can declare like this also, but it is always we should try to declare in this format. Fine it is now. Now there is one more important point about this. The fourth important point that final, suppose I'm just writing one example first. You see here that example. I'm writing one example. Class, hello, I'm writing. Int A. Int B. Into C. Static final int D. I've written some variables. I'm just writing some of the variables. And now I'll be trying to print all the variables of the class. A, B, C, as well as the D I'm doing. JTC, which one? It's a 3. I'm just... Here, I'll write the main method. A very simple thing which I'm doing is, I'm just creating the object of the class called as hello. I'm taking as simple as example could be. Okay, now as I'm trying to save it with the JTC 3 dot, what is that now? Java, and as I have saved it here. Well. G drive simply here I'm writing G. Now again I'm trying to write JTC, which one now? See here, it's JTC 3. So JTC 3.java, we are getting some errors. What error we are getting? Error is, the error what we are getting here is that the final variable, it is giving B as well as D. I'm assigning some value to this 101. And here I'm assigning some value, which is, you can say, some 111 I'm assigning. I've assigned these two values. Now again, I'm compiling this program. JTC3 I am writing dot Java. Could not find our, one second. Now I am running this program. What we are getting here now? In first case 0, 101, 0 as well as the 111. Now you see here. For variable A, we haven't assigned any value, even though it is showing it that 0 here. But when I have not assigned any value to the variable B, in this case, if I have not assigned any value, it is giving here the compilation error. Whereas similarly in the case of D. So see, you can understand one point that in the case of, final variable in Java. Developer must have to assign value to the final variable explicitly. JVM will not assign default value automatically. Did you got my point? It will not initialize default value automatically. We must have to initialize it explicitly. Okay, we must have to initialize this value explicitly, or else JVM will not be initializing it. Now see here, the difference. Now see, one question is here that is it always some questions with the final variable, and that answers will be finding it out. The question number one is, question is it important to assign value to final variable at the time of declaration. Second question is, question number two is, can we change the value of final variable? This is one question. Second question, the third question is, that what is difference between
static final and only final,
variable, right? Question, next question is again that is static final variable also must be assigned at the time of declaration, or can we assign at some other time also? These all are very, very important questions, Ray. Getting my point? As I have just given here, these all are the very important questions related to all this. Now, when I'm talking about, is it important to assign value to the final variable at the time of declaration? No, it is not important to assign value at the time of, or is it, it is not necessary to assign value at the time of declaration. There are the many ways to declare the, assign the value. Number one, at the time of declaration, first thing. Second one, now with the help of blocks And third important point is with the help of constructor, we can, there are these three different ways by using which we can initialize the final variable. We will come to that point again when we will discuss all this corresponding topic as such.
No, we just saw the example, right? When you did not initialize the final variable, it was showing compilation error, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it
actually,
you gave that a declaration.
Actually, this, I got your point. In this program, we are not using other properties. See here, if the same thing, variable B is there, right? Is it final? See here, I'm not initializing now. I'm compiling it. It will give error. It
yeah,
is giving,
it should,
sorry. One second. It is giving error. B might not have been initialized.
Yeah.
See, I'm initializing with the help of one block. B is equal to 101. I'm initializing with the help of block. Initialize now. See, it is not giving any error. It is not giving any error. We got it, right? We got it. So this is one technique. Similarly, other techniques are also there which, by using which we can change the, or we can initialize the value. Getting it? That's the reason I've just given here the different forms itself that we can do this. There are the different forms. Are you getting it?
Okay.
I'm not getting you, Sri.
Okay, okay. No, I just trying to understand what is the block and the constructor.
It will come. It will come in the further classes. I'm just giving you a complete information about the final variables and related to that final variable, all these things. Or else I would have finished within 2 minutes itself the final variable, right? Because a variable, if you declare it as a final, that will be treated as a constant. No need to give this much declaration, explanation. Okay. So it will come in further classes. It will come. And here, whatever I am giving, it's a complete information about the final variable I am giving you. Okay. Now the thing is, we have the final value. So can we change the value of a final variable? Tell me.
No.
Sorry?
We cannot change.
We can change the value of a final variable. That's the reason it is called as final variable. I'm not getting you. Your sound, you're not audible.
I know that for the country, India means like basically that like it's a final, right? You cannot change the final.
I said it as a static final.
A static final means like it's a common one actually. So with
yes,
the
yes, yes. Now let me complete once, you will get the complete idea. Okay. So final, which means can we change the value of a final? Yes, we can change the value of a final variable. Yes, we can change the value of final variable, but the final variable must not be assigned at the time of declaration, right? It must not be assigned at the time of declaration. I hope you are getting it.
Yeah, if you declare means you cannot change it.
Yes,
but,
that time you cannot change. And now, if we are changing, so for that we will be using, and once you have initialized in any form in that particular instance, you cannot change that value. Suppose, the what explanation I have given, try to understand from that previous explanation. I told SID, right? 101. Now SID 101 can't be changed for the Sri, means for the particular instance you cannot change that value, right? But for another one we can change it. 102 I'm making it.
Yeah.
Okay. So that can be done with the help of constructor. Okay, na? So when we will see the constructor topic, that time we will see. Hope you know the answer of these questions. What is difference between static final and final variable only? And is there any static final variable also must be assigned at the time of declaration, or we can assign? Yes. Static final variable, we have one option at the time of declaration. Second option is with the help of static block. No other option. What is static block? We will again discuss it in
that. I'm just reading that the questions are, is that static final variable also?
Is that static final variable must be assigned at the time of declaration? Yes, we can initialize at the time of declaration. What I'm asking question is, static final variable, is that it also has to be assigned at the time of declaration? Yes, we can assign, or we can assign some other time also. Or can we assign at some other time also? Yes, we can assign some other time also. That is the with the help of static block. Hope you are getting it.
Yeah.
Hello.
Just if it is variable, is just final ins, final also we can do the same thing, right? The time of declaration or the time of constructor also.
Constructor at the with the block. But if it is static final, we cannot go with the constructor.
Oh, we cannot go with the constructor, with static final.
Yes, we cannot go with the instance block. We can only and only go with the static block.
I don't know much about static, but anyhow.
Yeah. You don't know about that. That will come in the further classes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, from today's session, any question? Lots of questions might be there from the today's session.
Yeah, but good thing is at least I got that understand what is final like and how that memory allocation, that common one with that example.
Mm-hmm. Any other thing from this? Generally what happens that if we just wanted to complete the final variable, we can say that if I just wanted to give I or else if we, in order to complete just the topic, what we can say is the say if it's a variable int a is equal to 10, the value of this can be changed, right? Now, second point, what I can say, in order to declare it as a constant, final int of b is equal to 20. Now, it is a constant and the value of b cannot be changed because it is a final. Topic is completed. Did you got my point? But just to have the complete in-depth explanation, so I explained you all these details, these many things, options, these many options here, right? So that you should have the proper knowledge about all that. Okay?
Yeah, that is the reason we are saying final variable also. We are adding that.
Yes, variable. Yes. I was explaining that itself, that we are saying about final variable. Why we are saying it as a final variable? Why don't we say it as a final constant?
Otherwise, you can say as a variable also, like when you are saying just like a regular integer. The reason is, it looks like that I understood, but tomorrow morning.
No. Again.
Something got triggered, right? Like something got triggered. Like I think even an experienced person also may not say about this, why you are seeing a variable for a final.
Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah, a nice session, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Fine. So if anything else is there, you can ask.
That's fine, sir. So this one, I will definitely go through that note.
Mm-hmm. That's fine.